Let us quickly recap what we have discussed so far. The fundamental objective of research is to add to the field of knowledge. This can be in the form of theory building. This can be in the form of addition of more insights. This can be in the form of addition of more knowledge, which may be presented in some other meaningful form. The starting point of research is a problem, an issue, or something that can trigger the beginning of the research. Every researcher should spend considerable time in identifying important research issue. Research issue should be such which can really benefit the mankind, which can contribute to the welfare of the entire world. If you undertake a research which doesn't contribute to the benefit of the mankind, then why are you wasting your time and energy? So this is the starting point. We have discussed that there are two basic approaches to research: positivist, phenomenological. Both these approaches are Western approaches. I have not talked about Indian approach, because Indian approach is not discussed anywhere in research methodologies. Indian approach is very different from the Western approach. The Indian approach says the source of knowledge is inside. The Western approach says the source of knowledge is outside. The Indian approach says that if you have to search knowledge, you have to enter into yourself. You have to inquire into yourself. You can find out every knowledge from within yourself. So there is no need to go outside. The Western philosophy says that if you have to find knowledge, you have to look outside, check out the things from your eyes, from your ear, from your hands, experience it, document it, make it sure that you are 100% right, your observations are accurate, make it available to the world so that others can also experience it and others also can verify that this is really knowledge. So look at the difference. The Indian philosophy says the source of knowledge is inside you. You don't have to look outside. Every knowledge, every information, anything that can be there in this world is available inside you, your own self. You don't have to go outside. So this is Indian philosophy, and the opposite to it is Western philosophy. The source of Indian wisdom, Indian knowledge has been meditation. The source of Western knowledge has been scientific experiments conducted in laboratories. So now we are talking about the Western perspective, not Indian perspective. Now in Western perspective, we have two approaches: positivist approach and phenomenological approaches. The popular methods in positivist approach include survey, experiments, longitudinal studies, cross-sectional studies. Survey is a very popular form of research in the field of management, social sciences, wherein you identify a set of questions, circulate them to a random sample of a particular population which meets your criteria. Collect the data, undertake its statistical analysis, and try to interpret the findings. Experimental researches are most common in engineering, science, technology, agriculture, biosciences, where you undertake an experiment. You undertake measurements before the experiments and after the experiments with a control group. You find the difference between the data that you have identified, the control group and the experimental group. If the difference between them is significant, that means there is some impact of the research. the experiment has something. The experiment needs to be identified, and the hypothesis testing has to be carried out, which may result in some significant findings. Then we have longitudinal studies. They are very useful, especially in biosciences. Biosciences and in technological sciences, longitudinal studies can be very useful. Longitudinal studies are conducted for a very long period of time. Over a long period, let's say 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 50 years, you conduct an observation, find out what are the factors influencing certain phenomena, and based on that, you report the data. So longitudinal study and the cross-sectional studies, where a small sample from different target populations, on them you can undertake a study wherein you can use researches in the form of a longitudinal study or other studies. And in phenomenological studies, you can conduct qualitative research studies, which may include case study, participant observation method, action research, grounded theory, ethnographic studies. So these studies focus on qualitative studies. So qualitative studies are called phenomenological studies, and quantitative studies are what we call as positivist methodologies. We have discussed that when we are conducting a research, there are certain steps involved in the process of research. What are those steps? The first step is, as we have discussed already, identification of research problem, broad area on which you want to undertake a research. Then you have to dig into that area through literature review. And literature review will help you in identifying and zero down of your major objectives and minor objectives. And then you can clearly state your research objectives. You may pursue only this one research objective, no problem. But it should be very clear, very meaningful, and should state clearly what you want to achieve at the end of your research. So defining your research objectives is a very important step. It should be thoroughly conducted. The researcher should spend considerable time, resources, should take frequent guidance from supervisors, and prepare very meticulously designed research objectives, because they will be the most important milestones to be achieved. They will help you in undertaking your research properly. So research objectives are very, very important steps, very, very important steps. They have to be very clearly defined. And based on your research objectives, then you have to clearly spell out your research methodology, for which again you may have to consult literature review. You have to identify what was the methodology used by previous researchers in the case where the similar objectives was there. You have to identify what was the methodology used by other researchers? What were the drawbacks? What were the problems encountered? What were the observations of previous researchers? So you have to identify them. And you have to prepare a detailed research methodology. Detailed research methodology would include your hypothesis, your research steps. If you are going to use sampling, then which kind of methodology are you going to use in sampling? There are so many methodologies. If you are going to collect data. What are the tools for data collection? Are you going to use questionnaire? Are you going to use a scale? Are you going to use observation? Are you going to use a structured questionnaire or unstructured questionnaire? Are you going to use a group study? So various methods of their data collection are there. Which type of methodology are you going to use for data collection? At this stage, you have to very clearly spell out your research hypothesis, your research framework, your sample size that you plan to go ahead with, your level of significance, how you will collect the data. You have to specify all these steps very clearly. And how will you analyze the data? You have to plan in advance. Which statistical methodologies will you be using? There are so many statistical methodologies. And you can develop new methodologies also. Who says that you have to use the existing methodology? You can develop new research methodologies. You can develop new statistical tools. No problem. So long as your tools are such which are clear, every other person can use them, can get the same finding that you have got, and they seem to be very scientific methods, fine, go ahead with them. During research, peer review is a very important process. Periodically undertake peer review. Peer review means what you are doing. Discuss it with other researchers, with your supervisors, and take their feedback, take their inputs. And as per the inputs, you can modify your research approach. Flexibility is essential in research. If you are preparing your research plan in advance, it doesn't mean that there is no scope for flexibility. It doesn't mean that there is no scope for changing as per inputs from your peers, as per inputs from your research supervisors, as per inputs from other professors. You can adapt it, you can change it. Research should ultimately benefit either industry or society or the nation. If there is no benefit of the research, immediately stop that research. Don't waste your time. And it is the duty of the research supervisor also to stop every such research which is just wastage of time and addition of another piece of useless book. Stop it. This will be, you know, putting additional time and resources. So many researches are there which have been conducted without any purpose, without any end result in mind, except only one end result, that somebody wanted to get a PhD or MPhil degree. He conducted a study. Thereafter, how much time is wasted? Time of the research supervisors, time of the research report evaluators, time of the research section of the university, and later on, all those people who will read that literature review, they will again find it a junk. So don't undertake any such research which doesn't contribute to benefit, to well-being of the mankind, to the well-being of the world. Time is very scarce. Conduct research only which can be meaningful, which can be useful, which can contribute to the world, which can help in solving the world's problem. We have so many problems in the world. If each of the researcher can take up one small problem, only 1% of the problem, look at how much contribution they can make. Look at the kind of impact that we can have. Every year, thousands of people conduct a PhD, and if everybody starts focusing on one small minute problem, we will have thousands of solutions. If everybody can start focusing on one, building one small significant case study, we'll have thousands of case studies. So you have to plan all your steps in advance and carry out comprehensive study based on the plan. But you have to keep reviewing the plan. Every 6 months or every 4 months, you should undertake review of your work, wherein you can undertake introspection. You can invite other researchers, you can invite your research supervisors, you can invite other academicians to come and discuss and review your work. And based on their inputs, then modify, can change. That is necessary. The people who are doing researches in the field of technologies or in the field of management must necessarily conduct their research with some industry, because their purpose is to help an industry. So their research must benefit. Industry does not mean one unit. Industry means the entire set of industry. Their research must contribute to some additional piece of knowledge which can help the industries. So it should be like this. So if industry is now facing the problem of recession due to corona, researchers can contribute and to the study, like some of you are doing researches on these issues, how to handle corona related issues. This is contemporary topic, to handle this present problem, to handle the current situation. But it would be more meaningful if you can take up some researches which can give findings which may be remain relevant for many, many years to come, for many decades to come. Because the research that you're doing on corona will die once the corona problem is solved. So the findings may not be very relevant subsequently. But if you undertake research on fundamental issues, the research will be meaningful and relevant. Doctoral studies should be on fundamental issues. Project studies, which you undertake during your post-graduation or graduation, project studies, minor projects, they may be on very specific problems, very specific issues. But if you are conducting a doctoral study, the study should focus on fundamental issues. The study should result in either theory building or addition of knowledge, which may remain relevant for a very long period of time. So keep these guidelines into mind while designing your research framework, while preparing your research topic, while preparing your research plan. After you have conducted these steps, we will again, now let us again come back to literature review. Literature review is a very important step. Literature review means you are going to look at issues which are similar to your work. So if you have to undertake research on the subject of organization development, then you have to undertake literature review, means some 30, 40 papers or 50 research studies done in the field of organization development need to be studied. What was their finding? How they conducted the study? What was their methodology? So when you are undertaking literature review, keep a diary. Write down name of the article, author, name of the author of the article, research methodology used, key findings, limitations, suggestions for future study. small points you can write down. The best thing is that you start reading abstracts. Today, we are fortunate. We have many excellent websites. Can you name a few websites which can help you in undertaking literature review? Google Scholar is one. InfliBNet is one. Yes.
Elsevier is one.
Yes, absolutely right. Any other? One is SSRN, Social Science Research Network. If you will search on Google, you will find SSRN. This website is also very useful. So these are important websites. Prepare a list of them. Periodically go to these websites. Write down your keywords. And you will find plenty of research papers available. You have to first read the abstract. Read the abstract only. From that abstract, you will come to know whether that research is really relevant to your work or not. If the research is not relevant to you, skip it. If the research is something relevant to your field, to your field of research, then you will have to read the complete research paper and prepare down these points. Which are the points? What was the research objective? What was the research methodology? What was the sample size? What was the finding? What was the discussion, conclusion, limitation, suggestions? So, a comprehensive research starts with literature review. And literature review will give you insights how you have to start. What will be your research steps? If prior to you, somebody has already undertaken a research, for example, you want to undertake research study on use of organization development tools for transformation of a university. Now you find somebody has already conducted research with the same topic. There is already published paper. What will you do? Yes, what will you do? Due to limited time and limited resources, it is advisable. Don't undertake same research when somebody has already undertaken a research, when somebody has already carried out a research, there is already knowledge available, then why do you waste your time and resources? Why don't you read that research? But if you say the research has already been conducted, but the previous researcher mentioned these limitations, or the previous researcher conducted this research only into a very narrow geographical area, and there is a need to conduct it in another situation. Fine, this could be a good justification for you to claim that I have to conduct this study because this was the situation in the previous research. People give this kind of justification. So you may also give this kind of justification. But my sincere advice is, avoid doing research on a subject on which prior researchers have been very good quality researches. Their findings are very relevant. There seems to be no need to undertake fresh research. This is my request. We don't have dearth of research issues. We don't have dearth of research problems. Therefore, dear friends, don't do research on a topic which has already been thoroughly researched. Don't do it. Use your scarce time and resources for helping the mankind. This is my humble request to all. Now, tell me, how will you prepare your research design? What criteria you will keep in mind? How will you prepare your research framework? How will you prepare your research blueprint, your plan? Your research plan will decide the quality of your work, right? The way you design your research will result into excellent quality of research work if you design so. So how will you design your research? How will you prepare your research design? How will you prepare your research methodology? Tell me. What will you do? Yes? Okay, so these issues we will discuss in our next classes. Tomorrow we will meet, but then we'll not meet on Saturday and Sunday. Thereafter, we will meet again on Monday. So, tomorrow, of course, we'll meet from 9 to 9:30 again and discuss these issues. Our research methodology classes are open for everybody. Everybody who is interested can come. Whatever his education background is, whatever the person is doing, whether the person is a student or not, doesn't matter. Whether the person is working or not, doesn't matter. These are open classes for everybody. Everybody is free to come. The purpose is, through the discussion, if somebody can become a better researcher, or if somehow we are able to have a brainstorming on these issues, it may contribute to improved quality of research. Thank you, everybody.